So you're a young professional who wants to help the planet but doesn't want to be broke their whole life or work until they're 75. I'm right there with you, and in fact, I've been conducting a lot of research recently to help myself manage both goals. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing a few different jobs you can pursue to still earn a decent living and feel good about the work you're doing. Let's get into it. I did link all of the sources below in the description, so if something doesn't sound right, do me a favor and check the sources before commenting. Thank you. This is a part two to the 10 highest paying jobs that I posted almost exactly 1 year ago today. So if you haven't seen that full list, go check it out first. This is meant as an addition to that. I'll link that up in the cards right here. To start us out, we have the carbon finance specialist. They work at the intersection of finance and environmental science with a specific focus on carbon markets. Even right now, there are a number of incentive programs for institutions to purchase carbon offsets and participate in the carbon market. And these carbon finance specialists will help those organizations manage and reduce their carbon emissions by participating in these offsets or other carbon incentive programs. They will be essential for any company who wants to become carbon neutral or have net zero emissions, or in any state or jurisdiction that has regulatory requirements related to emissions for a certain company. On Glassdoor, their median salary was $76,000 per year in the United States. Our second job is the environmental economist. They conduct research about environmental events, and then they'll predict how that event will impact the economy on a local, state, national, or global scale. Some will focus more on modeling certain outcomes, others will work on environmental incentive programs, and even others will work in sustainable investing. According to Forbes, their median salary for 2023 was $115,730. As of 2022, the number of jobs was 17,600, and the estimated job growth from 2022 to 2032 is 6%. I will also note that for most of these roles, you will want a master's degree or a PhD in economics or environmental economics if the school has it, but that work will end up paying off. Our third job is the environmental data scientist, and their primary role is to analyze environmental data and provide insights for organizations to make decisions related to sustainability. They'll actually use data from environmental scientists who are in the field through a number of different sources, and then essentially translate that data that was collected into numbers that the organization can actually use and work with. This role is relatively new, but is becoming more and more in demand as companies move towards the sustainable transition. And with that higher demand comes an increase in salary. So according to ZipRecruiter, the median salary in the United States is $122,738 per year. Our fourth job on this list is the green building architect. These are essentially architects that have a focus on designing buildings that are sustainable, energy efficient, and generally eco-friendly. They'll sometimes specialize in incorporating sustainable materials into their designs, reducing water consumption, and implementing water conservation strategies into their design. And some might incorporate on-site renewable energy to the building to help reduce emissions. Right now, the construction industry has a lot of pressure to reduce their overall greenhouse gas emissions, so these green building architects are going to be a pivotal role in making that transition. According to ZipRecruiter, green building architects make $128,756 per year in the US. And that brings us to the fifth and last job on this list, which is the sustainable product manager. They are in charge of products that have certain sustainability requirements. Their main role in an organization is to manage any products that are produced by that company sustainably. A large part of their role will be to conduct life cycle analyses for that specific product and to do market research so that they can compare the sustainability of their product to other products on the market. Their work can be highly diversified as they coordinate with the design, manufacturing, and marketing teams to get that product developed and on the market. And as consumers drive up the demand for sustainable products, companies are looking to hire more and more of these professionals. According to Glassdoor, their median salary is $214,000 per year. And this is a great option if you are wanting to keep your wallet full and still make an impact. All right, folks, those were the five high-paying jobs in sustainability. If you liked this video and want to increase your earning potential even more, check out this video over here where I show you exactly how to negotiate your salary for any environmental job. Have a lovely rest of your day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.